So let us start with new problem which you people are watching on the screen by the method of joint again. Here the first step is to perform whether it is a perfect or imperfect type of a truss, for which we should know how many number of members are present, how many number of joints are existing. So once you know this particular data, you can utilize the governing equation of the type of truss, that is M is equal to 2J minus 3. Now, once we have identified this, what type of a truss it is, then we should proceed further. So, first step, whatever lengths or the members are there, they are been given. So, here members as well as lengths are already given in the problem. So, it means we don't have to actually find out what are the various lengths. So, horizontal are having all 3 meter, vertical members are all having 3 meter. The inclined member is equal to 4.242 meter. All these are been given in millimeter, but for the analysis we are considered into the meters here, 3 meter 3 meter. After this, what we are going to do? Type of truss. So number of members 9, number of joints 6. So 9 is equal to 9, that is a perfect truss. Second thing, we have to find out the geometrical parameters like angles and the lengths. So we know tan theta is equal to 3 by 3 is equal to 45. So theta is equal to 45. After that, consider the equilibrium of whole truss and find out the support reaction. So here you can see this particular truss is supported by a hinge at A and roller at particular point F. So one reaction at F and two reactions at A. This being a hinge support, there will be two reactions. Is that okay? So we have understood this particular part also. So let us find out the magnitude of the support reactions by considering the equilibrium of whole truss. So apply the conditions one by one. Sigma fx is equal to 0. Do the algebraic summation of all the forces here in this particular truss. So what we are having, HA plus HF is equal to 0. Sigma FY is equal to VA minus 100 minus 100 minus 50 minus 50 is equal to 0. So we got VA is equal to 300. So we have found out the first unknown VA. One more condition of equilibrium is available. Why third condition is available? Because we are considering the whole truss, which is an example of a coplanar force system. So we can apply the third condition, sigma m about point A is equal to 0. So here you can see, so here we are taking the moment about point F. We are taking the moment about point F. So do the algebraic summation of moment about point F. So HA into perpendicular distance 3 plus 300 into perpendicular distance 3 plus 100 into perpendicular distance 6 plus 50 into 6 plus 50 into 3 is equal to 0. So here there was only one unknown present, HA. So I found out the value of HA is equal to minus 450 kilonewton. Is it okay? Means HA is coming out to be negative, means assumed direction is wrong. So this is not acting in this direction, it has to act in the opposite direction. So we have found out this. Now using the value of HA equal to minus 450 in equation number 1, so there you will be getting HF is equal to 450. So here HF is equal to 450. As HF is coming out to be positive, means what? Assumed direction of HF is correct. Only the assumption has been wrong in this particular A force, HA. It is not in the positive X, it is in the negative X direction. So once you perform this particular third step also, now we are available with all the known reactions available due to the supports provided externally. So external support reactions already we have found out. Now the remaining job is what? To find out internal member forces. So there are 9 members. We have to find out the magnitude of the forces in each and every member. For that, what we are going to do? Obviously, identify the number of joints, draw the free body diagram, whatever is available, and after having that understanding of free body diagram, within that particular joint, assume the direction of forces and start with the minimum number of unknowns. So here you can see I have corrected the sign of HA, I have shown all the known forces. Now the job is to identify or encircle this particular joints one by one. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there are 6 joints to be understood, is it okay? These are the 6 joints which are to be analyzed further, and whatever is available into this particular circle, that will be the free body diagram of that individual joint. So here for joint C, 100 is available, this member force will be available, that is BC force, and here in this member there will be CD force. Assume the direction for all these BC and CD about this particular joint. Then talk about this 100, AB member force, BC member force, BD member force, BE member force, is that okay? So all these free body diagrams are right now in the first state available to you. I am not going to draw each and every free body diagram at the initial stage, but for the sake of understanding and understanding the steps which are to be performed, so that I have drawn in this particular slide. So here, after drawing the or imagining this particular encircled part, select that particular joint where there are minimum number of unknowns. Now when we are going to start with the analysis of the joint, we have understood it is going to be a concurrent force system. So in concurrent force system, we can apply only two conditions of equilibrium, that is sigma fx and sigma fy is equal to 0. So while having that particular joint, we should see there should be only two number of unknowns known, is it okay? Let us talk about this joint C. If I assume tensile BC force, I assume this. So how many forces are unknown here in this particular joint? BC and CD. Is that okay? This third force is known to you. So this is one appropriate joint where I can start with the analysis of the joint initially, right? So this is an ideal one joint which I feel proper. This is another joint. How many forces are meeting here? 3 member forces and 1 known force. So we cannot start with this initially. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 4 members. There are 4 members and 1 known force. So I cannot start with E also. At point F joint, there are only 2 members, AF and FE. AF and FE are the only 2 members. So this is another ideal joint to start with the analysis. So first is C joint, second is F joint. In F as well as in C, there are only 2 unknowns. I cannot start with this because 3 members are meeting here. I cannot start with initially this because there are 4 members meeting. So I concluded from this particular knowledge that there are right now only 2 joints which I can proceed with the analysis, that is joint C and joint F. So let us draw that particular free body diagram. So initially, for the sake of one time analysis for the slide, in this particular encircled part only I am going to identify the directions of the forces. So you can see I am going to assume the directions. I have assumed the direction of all the members. Though I know, I have to only start with joint C and joint F. Is that okay? Now what I am going to do is, I will consider, or first of all I will explore this whole figure and show all the forces. Now this may be very useful for you people to understand. What I talked earlier is everything shown in this particular thing. So here 2 members I can start, 3 members I cannot start, 4 members I can't start from this joint, I can't start with this joint because there are 4 members again. Here also there are 3 members. All these forces are not known to us initially. Now talk about F joint, only 2 members, 1 known force, we can start with F and joint C. Is that okay? So these are the two joints which I have to initially start with. Let us draw the free body diagram of the joint F and C one by one. See, for me the screen is available, so simultaneously I may take one or two or maximum three number of joint at a time. But for you people, you simply have to draw either joint C or either joint F. For the sake of animation and putting certain dynamics into the slides, I have to draw this particular joints simultaneously. But while doing the analysis, I have to go with one by one joint. Is that okay? So let us move ahead. So here I said, select a joint where there are only two number of unknowns, and then consider the free body diagram one by one. So here you can see I had two joints, joint C and joint F. Is it okay? This F was already here, C joint was already here. So in order to have a proper space available to do the analysis, I have shown it like this, right? So here, start with joint C or joint F, whichever is of your choice. So I am going to start with joint number C. This being a concurrent force system, three forces are available. Out of these three, one is known to you. So I am left with two types of method, or two ways by means of which I can do the analysis. Either go with the conditions of equilibrium or directly start with the Lemmas theorem. So I am here going with the condition of equilibrium. So minus FCV is equal to 0. There is only one thing remaining here. Is it okay? So this is an ideal condition to apply that knowledge of nil forces. Is it okay? If this is what is a force and this is the member, this is also going to carry a force. These two are collinear, so third has to be 0. This is proved here. Minus FCB has to be equal to 0. Next to that, sigma FY. So do the algebraic summation of forces in y direction. So minus FCD minus 100 is equal to 0. Therefore, FCD is equal to minus 100. So it is not tensile, it is compressive. It is acting in the upward direction, not downward. Is that okay? So I have found out FCB and FCD by the analysis of joint number C. So is there anything remaining here? No, we have found out both the unknowns. FCB is 0 and FCD is compressive 100. So I have to switch on to the next joint. So here joint number F. So at joint number F, this is joint number F. So apply the conditions one by one. So sigma fx is equal to hf, this is hf, plus ffe is equal to 0. So ffe is equal to hf is equal to minus 450. So it is compressive. So even if we don't have to do the analysis, see here, these two are going to be collinear, so they have to be what? Equal, opposite and collinear. If it is like this, it has to be in the opposite direction. If this is, these two are collinear, equal, opposite means what? This is 450, this has to be 450. So the more you solve the problem, the more you will get efficient in understanding and applying the basic knowledge on that particular truss. Is that okay? So here, this is what is the thing. Another thing, I can directly say the future of this FFA. Why? Because when there are three members, out of members or forces now, 450 and 450 are collinear, so third has to be what? This has to be equal to 0. You can prove it. So here FY is equal to 0, so only one force is there. FFA is equal to 0. Got it? So this is how we have to do the analysis for this particular joint F. So we have finished with joint C and F. Nothing is remaining as an unknown in this. Now after having this particular values of the various member forces, what we have to do? We have to go back to a original figure of truss, and there I have to show all these various forces, their magnitude as well as directions. So the very first truss which we have seen in this particular problem, go there and mark all those magnitudes and direction near that particular joint, and whatever far joint near that particular joint will be, it will be equal opposite and collinear. So you can see here what I am going to do. So here, after joining all these joints, what we are getting? Our original truss. What I said, consider this joint C and joint F which we have just analyzed, show the magnitude of the forces. So FCB we have to show, FCD we have to show. Far joint, you can see here, this is again FBC or CB. If this is 0, this has to be equal opposite and collinear. This is tensile, so this has to be tensile. How do I understand this is a tensile? Because this force is pulling this joint away. It is pulling, is it okay? So what it is? It is going to introduce a tension into this particular joint. Same is the case with this force. This force is pulling the joint if it has a magnitude. So that is what is the 0 and 0 force. Tensile nature, for the sake of understanding, I have shown it tensile. After this, joint F. So at joint F also, what is going to happen? This I have corrected the sign. Equal opposite and collinear, this is 0. So this member is FFE. So this is FFE, one and the same. So this has to be how? They have to be equal opposite and collinear. So here, if this is compressive, this force, so this also has to be compressive force. Is it okay? So this is also a compressive force. 450. So we have shown the opposite member forces of that joint. FFE I have shown, FFA 0 and 0 I have shown. So there is nothing left with joint C and joint F. Let us hunt for some other joint where there are again two number of unknowns remaining. Here at this joint 1, 2. Two unknowns here, 1, 2, and 3 unknowns here, again 3 unknowns. So we can proceed with this particular joint, joint number D. So I can draw the free body diagram of the joint, and let us see that first. Okay, here one more joint after D was this. Only two members are there, so I am right now available with joint A and joint D, which I can start with. So I will draw the individual free body diagram. After drawing that, I have to show whatever is known to you, and then I have to proceed with the analysis. So here we know what is to be done with the inclined forces. They are to be resolved. So here these are the two, so they are to be resolved. Here I have done the resolution for FAE. Similarly, one by one we have to start with the analysis, but for my sake of continuity of this particular thing, presentation, I have to do it simultaneously. So here, applying the conditions of equilibrium to joint A, apply sigma fx and sigma fy. So we can see here, minus 450 plus FAB plus FAE cos of 45 is equal to 0. Apply sigma fy. So, VA minus FAF minus FAE sine of 45 is equal to 0, but FAF is already equal to 0, so we can substitute that value also. So, here you can see I have done the substitution, and I am going to analyze or simplify this particular equation. So, I got FAE is equal to 424.26 kilonewton. It is positive, means what? This assumed direction is correct. So once I finish with this, I can move to the another one. So here, before moving, or let us directly move to the next joint D. So here you can see, after getting a value of FAE, I have substituted here in equation 1. So I got FAB is equal to 150 kilonewton. So no unknown is remaining here now. I have found out this FAB as well as FAE. After finishing with this, move on to the next joint, joint D. Inclined force was there, FDB. I have to do the resolution of that force. So here F DE and F DB. So F DB sin of 45 and F DB cos of 45. So now apply the condition one by one, sigma fx and sigma fy. So here, after putting whatever is known to you in this, so I got fdb is equal to 212.13. So this we have got fdb is equal to 212.13. So it is positive, means assumed direction is correct. Now once you get this particular value of fdb, put it in equation number 3. So there you will be getting FDE. So substitute it, you got a value FDE is equal to minus 150. Is it okay? So FDE is coming out to be what? Minus. So it is not in this direction, it is in this direction. So this corrected direction I have shown here. So with the analysis of joint A and joint D, again we have solved for the various four unknowns at joint A and D. After finishing with this, what is to be done? Whatever values we have found out, whatever magnitude and direction we have found out here in this analysis of joint A and D, all these values are to be transferred on the basic figure. So here you can see whatever basic figure I am showing all these as isolated, but we have a single truss after joining all these various things. There you have to show all this found out forces. So here whatever you can see by the red color are all been found out. Is it okay? There is only one thing remaining, I guess, that is F B E and F E B, and that two both are collinear. So for finding out that particular value, start with B joint or E joint. So here joint B and joint E. Again, inclined force we are coming across FDB cos of 45, FDB sin of 45. FDB is already been found out. Is that okay? Now we can do the algebraic summation of forces. In x and y direction, you can see. So here I did sigma FY minus 100 minus FBE minus FDB sin of 45 is equal to 0. So FBE I got equal to minus 250. So only unknown remaining was what? FBE, which was present with joint B as well as joint E. So now I have found out FEB as well as this particular FDB. Getting this? So this is BE and EB. So once we understand this magnitude 250, nothing is remaining now. If you imagine here in the earlier slide what we had, there was only one force remaining, FBE or FEB, one and the same, both are equal opposite and collinear. So that I had drawn the free body diagram of joint B and joint E. And there I did the analysis by conditions of equilibrium, and I found out a value of FBE is equal to minus 250. It is not a tensile force, it was a compressive force. So I have to correct the sign. It is not away, but it is toward the joint. So this particular corrected thing I have shown here. Is that okay? Now I have found out everything. So this FBE is the same FEB here. So in this you will find no any unknown force. Is that okay? Now once we have finished with all the member forces, we have found out their magnitude as well as directions. Now at once we can check it whether our analysis is proper or not. So out of all those number of 6-7 number of the joints, select any random joint where you all know the forces as well as the magnitude and their directions, right? So now if I am going to consider that random joint as E joint, so what happens here? I can apply the condition of equilibrium 1 by 1. So here, so in this only joint B only I have applied this particular check. So I am going to apply sigma fx is equal to 0 condition. Is it okay? So do minus 150 plus FBC is equal to 0 plus FDB cos of 45. This has to come equal to left hand side is equal to right hand side, means 0 is equal to 0. Minus 150 plus this term FDB, this value you already know, FDB, put that value. So left hand side is equal to right hand side, means when this left hand side is equal to right hand side, that is 0 is equal to 0, means whatever values for the forces we have found out along with the directions, we have done the analysis correct. Otherwise, if that is not equal, left hand side and right hand side, that is not equal to 0, then you may conclude that certain mistake has been committed in the analysis in some joint. And at that first mistake, it went on propagating from other joint to the next joint. So this is the random check. Even you can apply this particular check to this particular joint E. Is that okay? Apply sigma fx and sigma fy. So if I apply sigma fx, so what it will be? Plus 450 minus 150 minus 424.26 cos of 45 is equal to 0. So here left hand side should be equal to right hand side. Even if I can apply single sigma fy is equal to 0, this is also going to solve the purpose. So here this is a random check, how we can check whether the analysis is going proper or not. Is that okay? So here we have finished with all the number of unknowns here. So I am applying the check here. So after applying sigma fx is equal to 0, I got 0 is equal to 0, means what? The analysis what we have done up till this particular joint number E, all analysis were properly done. That's why at random joint E, I got 0 is equal to 0. In between, I have applied the check here also. So what is the usual procedure? Select a joint, apply the conditions of equilibrium. What we are used of? We are applying the first condition as sigma fx. But after application, you came to know that 0 left hand side and 0 right hand side. You should not get confused, because actually in horizontal direction no force was unknown. So every force was known to you, and you are applying the condition of equilibrium. Then in all the horizontal direction, that joint is in equilibrium. That is what has been proved here, as the algebraic summation of all the horizontal forces about this particular joint are equal to 0, means the B joint is in equilibrium. So this is what is that particular check. So same happens in this sigma fy also about this joint. Is it okay? If I do the sigma fy, then left hand side would be equal to right hand side, means once again what we conclude, joint E is in equilibrium in x as well as in y direction. So when all the joints are in equilibrium and they are being placed in a single truss, means the whole truss is going to be in the equilibrium. So this is the way how we have to analyze the problem step by steps. So by this time you have understood what are the various steps. First step, to find out whether what type of a truss it is. Second, find the geometrical parameters. Third, identify a joint where there are two number of unknowns. Why only two number of unknowns? Because that single joint is going to give us the concurrent force system. In concurrent, we should have maximum two number of unknowns. So this is how we have to traverse from joint to joint with the judgment that that particular joint has only two number of unknowns. Apply sigma fx, sigma fy and find out the answers. And after finding out the answers, check out whether the answer is positive or negative. If the answer comes out to be negative, we conclude that that particular magnitude is okay, but direction assumed is wrong. So FBE here was minus 250 FBE. So this was not tensile, it was a compressive force. So once you have the understanding of this particular joints one by one, I urge to transfer all these magnitudes into your basic truss figure, so that it will be very easy for you people to understand now with which joint I have to move further. So after following all these various procedures, you will come to a particular point where there is no any unknown remaining in the truss. So this is the only standard procedure by means of which we have to do the analysis by the method of joint. So after applying the first condition, sigma fx is equal to 0 at joint A, we concluded 0 is equal to 0 means whatever analysis we did is correct. Now similarly, we can apply the second condition for joint E, that is sigma fy is equal to 0, and check whether you are going to get satisfied with the analysis. Yes, after putting all the forces and the components in horizontal direction, doing the algebraic summation, that is equated with 0, and after simplifying the left hand part, we came to understand 0 is equal to 0. That means the analysis is going in a very proper direction. No any mistake has been committed in the earlier analysis. So after finishing with all these number of joint, what we have to do? We have to thoroughly go through each and every joint and see, is there any unknown remaining? So let us go through all these various joints. So here on your screen you can see whatever has been written in the red color, those were the earlier unknowns. Now they are being shown in red color, means we have found out each and every unknown present in the members. So no any unknown force is remaining, neither the external unknown, that is reactions, are unknown, neither the member forces are unknown. So we have performed a thorough analysis and we have found out the forces in each and every member, and at last we have to compile the whole data with respect to magnitude and direction. First of all, in the basic figure, problem figure, so here you can see I have shown the external support reaction as well as internal member reactions. I have shown along with the magnitude as well as direction. Now at last we have to compile all this data. This was a given data, members and the various lengths. Now we have to compile the force magnitude and the nature. So here are the forces and their magnitude, and then we have to go with this particular nature. So after compiling this whole data, we can say we have finished with this thorough problem. I hope you have understood the whole procedure of analyzing the various stresses by the method of joint. So this is what we have for the method of joint for today's numerical. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.